Wake up. I'm Wayne, and I'm an alcoholic. This is One Sober to Another. Welcome back to the channel, and thank you for subscribing if you've taken the chance to be with us and to talk about all things recovery, sharing your experience, strength, and hope. Have you ever told yourself, today's the day I stop drinking? Today is the day I have my last drink. And then you find yourself drinking anyway. Let's go. I think it's bad enough now to where I should probably stop drinking. You know what? It's just not that simple, folks. And if you've been where I was, then you understand entirely. I had the privilege of talking to somebody named Leah this morning, and she is 50 days sober, folks. And that is an amazing thing, and that's an amazing feat, and I'm so proud of her for getting where she is now. Here's the question. When does it get better? When does my mind start to get clearer, and when will things start to be fun again? The answer is not always so clear, and it's gonna take some work and time to get there, but first, you have to be able to ask this question. When is it bad enough that I'm gonna stop drinking? What actually has to happen in my life for things to tell me it's time to stop drinking? Now, if you're an alcoholic like me, that answer is not exactly simple. If you're a problem drinker or maybe just someone who likes to party, that answer might be as simple as put the glass down and just stop drinking, period. It's not that easy for an alcoholic like me. Sometimes you have to hit the rock bottom in order for that to happen. I don't wish rock bottom on anybody because I'm telling you, that is a place that you might not get out of, but the hard questions have to be asked. When is it enough? Do I have to be in the hospital? Do I have to get arrested? Do my kids have to go away from me? Does my spouse have to leave? What has to happen in order for me to realize that this drink is not my solution anymore? You know, I'm an alcoholic, and for me, it took a couple tries in order to get it right. Now, relapses are essentially a part of recovery. I got it and I understand. However, it's not an excuse to go back to the drink just because, yep, relapses are a part of recovery, therefore it's okay if I do. You know what? You might not make it back, man. And that's really, really the truth of it all. My camera's playing tricks on me today, folks, so if it skips a little bit, you know why. So where was I going with that? Recovery takes time. Recovery takes work. And those hard questions, am I gonna stop if I get promoted? Am I gonna stop, you know, if I have a child? Am I gonna stop if I move? All these things. Each individual person is different, and I'm not here to preach to you folks, because take it from me, I'm not an expert. I'm not an expert on, you know, the physicalities of alcoholism. I'm not an expert on, you know, the disease of alcoholism, but I do know that I'm 5 years sober, and I am living proof that recovery is possible, as well as millions of other people. So if you think you're alone, folks, you're not. We are in it together, and that's exactly why there's a bunch of us here on YouTube who do these channels for you. And if you want to be a part of it, it's real simple. Just DM me on Instagram, Twitter, or Reddit, or PM, or DM, or whatever, and, you know, I will gladly bring you on the channel to share your story like a few others have, and just share your experiences with the rest of the world. Because this disease is all of us. It's not just me, and it's not just you. There's so many people out here suffering, and especially with this pandemic time and everything else. And I think I lost my train of thought. So the theme of this video is, should you stop drinking? You know what? There's no easy answer. Your rock bottom, or your point to where you're gonna decide the drink is not working for you anymore, is your own. And unfortunately, nobody else can help you decide if you're an alcoholic either. That's on you. Now, alcohol dependence can be diagnosed, and, you know, those scientific things behind it. But if you determine yourself to be an alcoholic, then you know there's work that has to be done in order to change your life and change the quality of life that you're living. Because what you're doing right now, and self-determined, doesn't work. what I was doing in my life, drinking every day from 1700, that's 5 o'clock for you American folks, all the way up until I passed out, and then getting up at 3:45 a.m. the next day, 03:45, to go to work and do it all over again, was the vicious cycle that I was on. I eliminated my family, let me rephrase that. I took them out of my life so that they couldn't tell me how to drink. Any friends that didn't want to drink with me, I eliminated them as well. I took them out of my life too. And my phone had an off button, so I didn't answer that thing either if it was somebody who was going to tell me how to drink. A lot of things went wrong in my life and I lost a lot in order for me to realize that alcohol wasn't working for me anymore. That's how I knew that I had to make a decision if I wanted to live or die. If I wanted to live or die, and if I wanted to have a good life or not. Those are the ways that I knew that I had to stop drinking. And I knew also that I couldn't do it alone. Me, personally, I reached out to the folks in Alcoholics Anonymous, and might not be your thing, I understand that. But for me, that's what worked, is I got the support from other alcoholics and addicts, just like me, who found the way to recovery, and I did what they did. You know, that's kind of like, you know, you see somebody doing something excellent and superior and you want to be just like that, a good athlete or a good singer or a good musician. You do what they do until you figure out your own route. That's what I did, folks. And, you know, that's how I knew that my decision to stop drinking was the best one that I could have done, because I'm pretty certain right now I wouldn't be standing here. I'd probably weigh 112 pounds, drunk out of my mind, with no food in my stomach, probably no shoes on my feet, and roaming the earth just by myself because no one else wanted to be around me anymore. That's what it probably would have been like for me, and I don't want to know how it would be like. So therefore, I'm not going to pop the top on those bottles, and I'm not going to drink anymore, and I'm not going to drink with you today. And folks, I hope this little tidbit video is a little bit of something for you to chew on. I can't tell you if you should stop drinking or not, and I can't tell you what your turning point will be. However, I can tell you that there is light, and if you're an alcoholic like me, there is hope for recovery, and we are here for you. I am here for you, folks. To all the folks who have been part of this channel, I thank you, and I appreciate your support, and all the subscribers, you guys are fantastic. I appreciate your support as well, and I look forward to doing more videos for you. If you want to see certain content, just let me know. If you enjoyed this video, do that like thing and drop a comment, because someone else is going to get some of that, folks. Life is a daggone garden. Dig it? Guess what? I'm going to see you in the next one, and I hope you enjoyed this view this morning. Bye-bye.